part 2. For months and years, Molai worked all alone on the small patch of the island. He lived in the company of trees. He spoke to them. Maybe the trees understood his language. They responded by growing vigorously.
Ma'am, I'm really impressed by Molai. I've seen people cutting trees and disturbing the nature. But he is an example to every human being. We should also try and make it a point to plant more and more trees.
Yes, that's true. Nature and animals helped Molai in his work. With trees came birds, insects, and animals. Unknowingly, they brought many more seeds to the place. The place began to get rich with different forms of life. The forest now became a second home for him. People in that area named it Molai's Kathoni, Molai's Forest. Today, Molai's Kathoni covers an area of nearly 1500 acres. And with Molai's efforts, it's growing every day. It houses thousands of different trees and plants and birds and animals, including deer, apes, and even rhinos and tigers. To cap it all, a herd of about 100 elephants has started visiting the forest every year. All this was not just smooth sailing, working in heavy rain and scorching heat. He also had to face opposition from the people. People started stealing from his forest. He had to guard his island against poachers. Elephant caused a lot of damage. They destroyed the rich fields and huts. Even Molai's own hut was destroyed. People wanted to beat Molai, but he was not afraid. He was firm in his resolve to create and protect a green cover for the land. Molai keeps cattle for his own living. His family supported him in all possible ways. People outside Molai's own tribe didn't know about Molai's work. One day, a photographer roaming in that area found Molai's working in his forest and guarding it. When he came to know that Molai had grown the forest single-handedly, he was greatly impressed. He told the media, newspaper, TV channels, etc. about Molai's single-handed achievements. The forest department was impressed too. They decided to help Molai in his work. The government honored him with the Padma Shri Award. Molai now wants to spend his message throughout the country. Each one of us should plant and grow at least 2 trees. The trees will take care of the carbon dioxide we produce throughout our life and give us enough oxygen to breathe. So children, what message do we get from the lesson?
Ma'am, we get the message that nothing is impossible if we do any work with dedication. We can be successful like Molai. Ma'am, from this lesson, we also get the message that what is the importance of trees? Molai, being illiterate man, understood the importance of trees and planted so many trees. So we who are literate and know how trees benefit us should also try to plant more and more trees to maintain the balance in the environment.
Very good.